Moving to the introduction, as AIship, a high altitude long endurance platform. High altitude is basically a relative term, because general airship, as you know at the end of this course, that they are normal airships used to fly from one place to another place. But this type of system remains aloft for a particular duration of time and serves as a platform for various purposes. That's why it is called high altitude long endurance platform, and it is placed around 20-25 kilometers. It is not actually, in comparison to the other systems, it is not a high, because satellite we use to satellite orbit is around maybe maximum 35,000 kilometers, and even at International Space Station is the orbit of, what is the height of that orbit? Anybody knows? What is the height of International Space Station? So it is around 400 kilometers. And so any of you have seen that International Space Station at the sky? Anybody? From ground? With naked eye? No. You can see, because there is a link, spot your station, and when you will register your email ID, they will send, NASA will send to you whenever it will cross above your city. Like whenever you will enter Mumbai, whenever it will cross over the Mumbai, and they will send some duration before as an alert. You can see that with the direction and time and the direction of, in which direction it will be visible. And especially at the night, you can see the moving light with a very high speed. Anyway, so these are the systems which perform, which can be used for the various purposes, mainly for communications, maybe for surveillance, and any other, many other applications we'll see in later stage. So high altitude long endurance platform. Long endurance basically is for, because it can stay at the that height for a couple of months, for 6 months, for even a year. That's why it is called a high altitude long endurance platform. And it is, remains a standstill and serves the purpose, a standstill platform. And it is very cost effective relative to the satellite, because designing and launching at orbiting at sending at that height is very cost effective related to the satellite, because in satellite you know how much risk is there and how much cost involved. So it is not it doesn't create a disturbance to the commercial aviations, because you know at what height maximum commercial aviation takes place? Maximum, yeah, max 7-8 kilometers. Whenever you fly, you will take a flight, they announce you 35,000 feet. So it doesn't create any disturbance. It is above that, the commercial flight. And the defense or fighter jet can go above that. That is a different thing. So why, question as arises, why it is placed only at the 20 or 25 kilometers? That's why it is the answer here. So the wind speed at that height is relatively lower. Below that, due to the higher wind speed, so at a wind speed, to overcome that drag, because this system used to be very big, and to overcome that drag, you will need a bulky power systems to overcome that drag. Otherwise, it will shift to the another location. So you can see in the increased volume due to the larger power. So to produce that large power, to overcome that large drag, you will need a large volume. Why large volume? Can anybody say? So this system used to be driven by the solar power. So for large area, because you need a large, big solar energy to place a such large solar area, solar cells, you will need a large space so that the system's size will increase. And if you go above that, then again size will increase because the density of air will go down further. So you can see here, increased volume due to lower density, and buoyancy, because you have to take care of payload as well. To carry that payload, it will need to displace a larger volume of light density of that air. So you will need a bigger size of airship for the same payload at higher altitude. Are you getting my point? So that's why 20 to 25 or 22 kilometers is optimum. So this is a conceptual image to demonstrate the it is in and that had to serve the different purposes. And when you see in India, there is a concept of placing around 20 airships to cover the entire nation, so that it can serve the purpose of communication as well as surveillance. Because particularly in India, it is very, very problematic problem to get a seamless connectivity. And you know, India is at the bottom in Asian continent, while we consider the speed of internet. And it is not fall under the 100 when you consider the entire world. India is beyond that because the low speed, and even you move from one location to another location, you will not get a seamless connectivity. And even nowadays, even remote location, they are not a feasible 3G connection or smooth 3G connection. The world is now talking about 5G, and we are struggling to get a 3G connections. That's our problem in remote location especially. And big cities, it is a problem of radiation and towers used to place for better connectivity. That is another problem, infrastructure. So it can serve a very good platform to cover the nation for communication systems especially. So what are the advantages over the satellite systems? It is self-launchable. You don't need a launcher. So don't need a rocket. You can bring it down, and then after refurbishing, you send it to back, which you cannot do in a satellite. And that is a big problem, actually, because after expiry, satellite used to be there and create a debris, and space debris is a big problem nowadays. So as you place it in a position, it starts serving. No global infrastructure or construction required. So these are the benefits of the satellite. And what are the various applications we can see? When you talk about defense, you can use under surveillance or guidance, or warning, and to observe border areas, and for civilian, maybe a communication is a big benefit from these systems. So we'll see a small video which will demonstrate the application of these systems. It will be clear. So let us see the video. It is a video of a Stratobus, a conceptual video.